This is Bowles. Anybody home? Doesn't seem to be anyone. Oh, Jesus. Wait a minute. This letter. Holy fuck. I hope she hasn't. Come on, I have to search the house. Maybe it's not too late. Hang on, baby. First, I gotta find Mama. Hello, little cutie. Oh? You're looking for your mama. Mrs. Bowles, are you there? Mrs. Bowles, can you hear me? Wake up! I'm gonna call an ambulance.
No, I don't want to go to the hospital. Please.
Okay. You got something around here I can dress this wound with?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, don't move. I'll be right back. Need some bandages and disinfectant. Gotta be here somewhere. Quick, she's losing blood! I gotta hurry. Let's see. I need this, and this, and this. I'm here for you, Susan. You'll be all right. I'll take care of you. Stay with me, Susan. Susan, do you hear me? Susan, stay with me. Can you hear me? Stay with me. Okay, come on. There, I done what I can. That should stop the bleeding. Luckily, the wounds aren't too deep. Hey, how are you feeling? Okay?
My baby needs me.
Right. You stay there. I'll take care of the baby. Okay?
Do you know what to do? With a baby, I mean.
I'm a private eye. There's nothing I can't do.
Her name is Emily.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Hi there, Emily. So, what seems to be the problem, huh?
Oh! Going by the smell, I got a pretty good idea. Okay. How do you do this again? There you go, fresh new baby. That should feel better. Right, Emily? Hey, what's the matter? I thought we solved the problem. Susan, I changed her diaper, but she's still crying.
She's hungry. There's a bottle in the kitchen.
Gotcha. I guess I better warm this thing up. Emily, are you hungry? Huh? You hold on. I'll just tilt this bottle a little bit so you don't choke. Oh, good job, Emily. You're feeling good now, right? Now, I'm gonna rock you very gently so you can have a nice little snooze. Right. That's about the limit of my maternal powers. Poor kid. Life ain't gonna be easy for her.
Thanks for looking after my baby. I didn't want to leave her. I just couldn't cope anymore. Not having Jeremy around. He was such a good boy. Can't understand why anyone would want to hurt him.
Do you take care of this baby on your own? Doesn't Jeremy's father live with you anymore?
He disappeared. The day after Jeremy. I don't know what happened to him. Maybe he couldn't take it. Ever since I've had to look after Emily all on my own and couldn't do it anymore.
I understand. Did your husband say anything before he disappeared? Did he leave a note or something?
No. He left the house without a word and there was just the cell phone.
A cell phone?
Yeah, I found a cell phone in his dresser. I'm sure it wasn't his. I'd never seen it before. I tried to turn it on, but it didn't work.
Do you still have it?
Yeah, it's in a drawer in the living room. You can have it if you'd like. I'm sure it's of more use to you than to me.
Do you have any family or anybody to help you?
Yeah. My mother. I didn't want to ask her for anything. We don't really get along. But I guess I'm out of options.
Well, look after yourself. And Emily.
I will. I promise.
Parking lot ticket and the origami figure leads to this garage. What am I going to find here?
Excuse me? Hey! Oh! Sorry. Didn't see you. What can I do you for?
I'd like to get my car.
Hey, you're a pretty patient guy, you are.
That
car's been there for 2 years.
But at least he's alive. I'll do anything to get him out of there.
Batteries, just like you said.
Have I been here before? I don't remember it.
It's the third floor down. The service elevator is at the far end of the garage.
Thanks.
Ah, you have yourself a good one, Chief.
Car's been here for 2 years. What does that mean? A car? Why am I being sent to look for a car?
Your destination is 4 miles from here. Leave the parking lot and take the first right.
I can do it. I'd do anything to save my son. If I succeed, I'll get more letters for the hangman. It's my only lead. No turning back now. I've got to do it. For Sean's sake. I have no choice.
I'd like a room.
For you? Anything. Feeling the register. Madison, page 27. Single. How long will you be staying with us, Ms. Page?
I don't know yet.
Room 201. Last floor, stairs on the right in the courtyard.
Thanks.
The pleasure was all mine.
That's for sure. Sir? Are you all right? I'll call an ambulance.
No ambulance.
You're badly hurt. You need a doctor.
Please, just help me to my room. It's number 207.
You got the key? You're really in bad shape. You should see a doctor.
Must have one, maybe two broken ribs. It's not fatal. But it's sore as hell.
Your head is bleeding. It looks deep. I'll help him first and ask questions later. He's in trouble. I can't just walk away and leave him like that. I should disinfect his cuts. I'm gonna disinfect your wound. This might hurt a little. There. At least it won't get infected.
Thanks.
Paracetamol painkiller. Administer in cases of intense pain. Do not take more than one pill every 24 hours. Here. Take this. It should do you some good. It's a painkiller. It'll help reduce the pain. It says on the box to take one every 24 hours. I don't think it's a good idea to exceed the dose.
I can't afford to wait.
I wouldn't move around for a few days if I were you.
I'm gonna take a shower.
Let me help you. I'll wait here until you come out. Let me know if you need anything. Talk to me. That way I'll know if you pass out.
What's your name?
Madison.
Are you staying in the hotel?
No, I live in town. I suffer from chronic insomnia. I seem to only be able to sleep in motels. Don't ask me why. Whenever I get too exhausted, I come and spend a night here.
I'm just passing through. And what else do you do, Madison? Apart from fixing up strangers.
I'm a photographer. I take pictures of furniture for fashionable design magazines. And you?
I'm an architect.
Thanks for staying. I feel a lot better now.
Okay. I better get going then. By the way, you never told me your name.
Ethan.
Be careful, Ethan.
Why didn't you shoot?
Sorry?
Well, back there, Nathaniel could have had a gun. Could have killed me. Why didn't you shoot?
I prefer to have all the information before I make a decision. I try to make rational choices when possible.
Come on, you had a fraction of a second to react. You could have whacked me before you had time to move.
Well, I'm sorry. I thought you were a tough guy. A street cop who's been through the mill. I didn't think you'd scare so easily.
Why don't you fuck off, Norman?
That's him.
Miroslav Korda?
Yeah?
Lieutenant Carter Blake, I'd like to ask you some questions.
Shit, don't just stand there. He's gonna get away.
Ah!
Hey, man, watch it. Ah.
Ah.
Watch it, man! Whoa!
This time it looks like we got our origami killer. Thank you.
You said I could contact you if I remembered anything. Can I come in?
Sure. Let me take your coat. You want a drink?
Yes, glass of water, please.
Take a seat, I'll get it.
Thanks. I just remembered something. Maybe it's not important, but a letter arrived in the mail the morning Johnny disappeared.
A letter? What kind of a letter?
It was addressed to Johnny's father. I don't know what was inside it, but he read it and then he left. That's the last time I saw him.
And you think there's a connection between that letter and Johnny's death, is that it? You remember anything else about the letter?
Well, I don't know why, but I kept the envelope.
It was mailed in the Carnaby district. The day before Johnny disappeared. Oh, nothing particular. Except the address.
The address?
It was typed with an old typewriter. Could be a lead, you never know. Well, thanks for your help, Lauren. I'll let you know if it leads to anything.
Wait, I can't just sit around and do nothing while you're out there looking for the man who killed my son. Ever since you came around, I've been thinking, and I want to come with you. Help you in your investigation.
There's nothing you can do to help, Lauren. It's not a good idea. Believe me.
If you won't let me help you, I'm keeping the envelope. It's all or nothing.
Listen, an investigation like this is dangerous, and I don't have time to play the bodyguard.
How many clues have you got, Mr. Shelby? This envelope, maybe your only link to the killer. I understand. It was a stupid idea. Sorry for wasting your time, Mr. Shelby.
Wait. You're really something special, Lauren. I'll give you that.
I'm just a mother. A mother who wants to find out who killed her son. Are we partners?
We're partners. Maybe you better stay in the car.
We're partners, remember? Wherever you go, I go. What are we doing here?
We come to see Gordy Kramer.
Kramer? The big wood tycoon from Kramer Construction?
No, his son.
You think maybe he's the origami killer?
For now, I just have a few questions that need answers.
Security guard earned his payoff. Seems there really is a party going on tonight. Stupid to bring Lauren. I don't do partners too well. All that just to get my hands on that stupid envelope. Security all over the place. I would say Gordy's just a little bit paranoid.
joint! Kramer must be loaded! What do you think he paid for all this shiny crap?
We'll discuss Kramer's decor another time.
Are we gonna be here long? This place gives me the creeps.
I'm gonna go find Gordon Kramer. You stay here till I come back, okay?
Okay. Just let me know if you need me.
Okay, gotta find Gordy Kramer. Don't know why they have that goddamn music so loud.
Hi! Great party, huh? Hi! Well, let's get better acquainted, pal! My kind of guy. I like you. My friend.
Maybe this job does have its perks. Now I got me a new friend. Finding someone who isn't smashed or doped up to the gills would be a miracle. And I need one right now. Hey, good-looking girl. Keep your mind on the job, Scotty.
Hi, I'm looking for Gordy. You know where he is?
I saw him a while back. You'll be lucky to see him. He rarely hangs out down here with his guests.
Oh, really? Why bother throwing a party, then?
Why don't you go ask him?
I haven't seen Lauren for a while. Better see what she's up to. Booze, babes, and coke. Gordy Kramer seems to be quite the party animal. Okay, gotta find Gordy Kramer.
Hi, I'd like to see Gordy.
Gordy isn't seeing anyone. Beat it.
Look. You just tell him that Scott Shelby wants to speak to him, okay?
You're starting to piss me off, man. Now beat it before I get angry.
If I want to see Gordy Kramer, I'm going to have to go about it some other way.
So, did you find Gordy?
He's upstairs. I got two goons blocking the way.
You want me to handle them?
Hey, what are you gonna do? Knock them out with a pair of high heels?
Leave it to me! Just be ready to go as soon as they leave the stairs!
Wait, Lauren.
Thank you.
Miss, are you all right?
Hey, wake up!
Shit! Another one's gonna OD on the dance floor.
Mr. Kramer?
Shh! This is the best part!
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the Origami Killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions. I'd like to know exactly what happened to little Joseph Brown.
Beat it! You hear me? Get the hell out of here!
What do you want?
A witness saw little Joseph Brown get in the back of your limousine. That was the last time anybody ever saw him. Now, I know you've been arrested and interrogated until your father made a little phone call and the file was closed. I'd like to hear your version of the facts.
The kid was lost. I just offered to drive him home. The police arrived, I explained the misunderstanding, and I was released. End of story. Nothing to get excited about, right?
Okay, so you're a good Samaritan, taking kids home who happen to get lost right next to your limousine? Now be a nice guy and tell me something I can't believe.
Very well. I'm the Origami Killer. I get my victims into my car. I drown them in rainwater. Then I dump them on a wasteland with an origami figure in one hand and an orchid on the chest. I do that because I'm bored, Mr. Shelby. And it's a creative and entertaining way of having fun. Is that good enough for you? Or do you want more? This interview is over.
Get rid of this clown! Oh!
Ow!
It's a dangerous game you're playing, Kramer.
Do you know who my father is? He only has to lift one finger and you won't wake up tomorrow morning. You're the one that should be afraid, Mr. Shelby. Not me.